Once the opportunity arose for him to close the show, he did it in emphatic style.
Whatever he hits falls.
Andrew McCart, IFL TV, in association with MTK Global. I'm here at Madison Square Garden. With me I've got the victorious Danning Cunningham III, aka DC3.
Yeah.
Can I call you DC?
Yeah.
Yeah, DC, I mean, you're just out the ring there, you were first on. How did you assess your performance?
I give myself a B+, you know. It's always room for improvement, you know. There's a lot more things that I wanted to do, but I had a great opponent in front of me, you know, and I'm just glad that I was able to showcase my talent and skills on him.
But you said you had a good opponent in front of you. This guy had like 40 plus fights. That was on your 10th fight. The experience was on his side. He's also fought former world champions.
Yeah.
So that's a
former
good,
and current world champions.
Former and current world champions. So yeah. It's a good test for yourself, especially on your 10th fight. Let's be honest, it's what you needed at this stage.
Yeah, it was good. You know, I'm glad I got the experience. I want to thank, you know, my promotion company, BHP, BH Events, Eddie Hearn, Matchroom, you know. I'm thankful for the opportunity. It was a great experience. What better place than a garden, you know?
Madison Square Garden.
It's a blessing.
Definitely. Well, you're in the Super Bantamweight division. It's a great division to be
yeah,
in.
Yeah, yeah.
I mean, you've got a smile on your face. We just mentioned it. Are you licking your lips looking at the champions in this division
now? You know, it's like this, you know, it's all a process, you know, so I can only take it one at a time, you know. I can't be 10-0 today and 20-0 tomorrow, you know, so I'm going to take it a fight at a time, you know. I'm going to continue to win, and it's not just about winning, but how you win, you know what I'm saying? So I'm going to keep learning, I'm going to keep growing, you know, and keep performing at my highest level.
That's the great attitude to have. You're with Devin Haney Promotions. Mm-hmm. I mean, you're seeing what Devin's doing. I mean,
yeah,
he wins tonight. He's mandatory for Lomachenko's WC belt. I mean, how far do you think Devin can go? Like, I spoke with Eddie today, he says he could be a 4-weight world champion. That's how much Eddie believes in him.
Yeah.
What's your thoughts on Devin?
Like, he's a future boxer, you know what I'm saying? And he like the face of boxing as of right now. You know, you can see, look at his following, look at his fighting, everything, you know. So he has a total package, you know, and he's leading by example. So it's like, with me coming behind him, you know, you can only expect great things.
Is that what you're gonna do? You're just gonna cruising behind Devin and do the thing?
That's the right way to do it, right?
Definitely, man. I'll do the same thing as well.
My cruise behind one of the best in the world.
So let's talk about Devin then. When you look at the current champions as Richard Comey and Lomachenko, how well do you think you'll fare against these champions right now?
He got too much skill for them, you know what I'm saying? Like I told you, all around great fighters. You know, he got a footwork, he got great hand speed, you know, and great power, so. You don't got that, then you don't have a chance. You know, I don't see too many guys like that. So.
Thoughts on Abdulev tonight? His fight against Abdulev?
Yeah.
You think he'll stop it?
Abdulev, yeah, he gonna eat a lot of shit tonight. I'm saying his foot be in the mud too much, so I'm saying he gonna be getting dirty tonight.
Well, that's a good analogy, but I'm gonna put this up here, so let's hope your prediction's right. But what's next for you going forward?
Before, you know, I look forward to getting the ring at least once, if not two times, you know, before the year out. You know what I'm saying? I didn't take any punishment tonight. I got the great experience. I'm happier than ever, to be honest.
You've got a big smile on your face, you can see it, definitely.
It's up for real.
I've got to say, man, like, Eddie has got Devin, he's working with Devin quite closely, but Eddie brings some of his fighters over to the UK. And you're saying you're going to just cruise in behind Devin. Would you love to come and fight in the UK?
I'd love to come over to the UK. Why not? They got amazing fans, you know, and they really support, you know, their fighters. You know, I think over here in the U.S., we have to support our fighters a little bit more, you know, in each and every way possible. You know, because it's a lot of great superstars out here, you know what I'm saying? But it's like, if we don't help get behind them, then guess what? None of us will never be as big as Joshua or any type of guys, you know what I'm saying? So.
You'd love to come out to the UK, and that's I'll have a word,
Eddie, bring me to the UK. Eddie, I want to come to the UK.
There you go. That's it. Eddie watches IFL, so he'll see this.
Eddie, bring me to the UK. They gonna love me. I was the first fight tonight. Had a crowd going crazy. It was lit. They love me. They love me. It was crazy.
I'm a fan already.
Thank
so
you.
There
I
you
appreciate
go.
It.
Yeah, but what's next? Like I said, what's next for you? But I mean, you can jump into a time machine and go 12 months from now. Where would you like to be?
12 months from now, I love the, you know, first I want to capture the youth title, the WBC youth title, you know. I'm still young, I'm still growing. I got a number of time on my hands, you know what I'm saying? Like I told you before, it's a process. You got to take your time, you know what I'm saying? So first I'm becoming a youth champion, and then, you know, an intercontinental champion, then a world champion. That's the only way.
That's it. Okay. It's the right path to take as well. Yeah. Right, DC, I won't keep you much longer, brother. But like I said, thanks for this live film TV and go and enjoy the rest
Eddie,
of the night.
Eddie, bring me to the UK. Eddie, bring me to the UK.
He watches
Eddie, bring me to the
he
UK.
You want to see this?
Okay. I want to go up to the UK, Eddie. Let's go.
You heard it here, Eddie. Yeah, thank you much, DC.
Opportunity arose for him to close the show, and he did it in emphatic style.
Whatever he hits, falls.